Good morning, students. Hope you are all very fine. Today, I am going to teach you the second year paper, namely school management. You know what is a school? Yeah, it's a place where we receive our education. Do you remember what are the various resources that you find in a school? Physical resources and human resources. What are the physical resources? The classroom, the buildings, playground, laboratory, library, everything comes under the physical resources. Then what about the human resources? The students, the teachers, the headmaster, the management, and other people who work inside the school and bring about a changes in the life of a child. They are the human resources. Now, I understand that you are able to classify the resources inside a school campus. One is physical resources, another one is human resources. Then, looking into the second word, management. What is management? Why we have to manage the things? I hope you know the basic meaning of managing the things. Yes, in a school, there should be a good utilization of both the physical and the human resources to bring about certain changes in the life of the people. Now let us see the meaning for the word management. Management comes from the French word manage, which means housekeeping. You know the function and the utility of a house remains in the hands of the people who keeps them very neat, clean, and a routine way of maintaining it. Likewise, school is a place where there should be routine maintenance of the things. So, school management means maintaining the things and in a cooperatively way to attain the objectives of education. You know, management is a comprehensive term and it is used in several disciplines. We would have used this management word in many places. Managing the time, managing the things, like it is used in various disciplines. What is management? It is not a simple process. It's a complex process of organization of the system which is utilized for proper utilization. You have to make the best utilization of the human and other resources to bring better outcomes. Management is a social process of inspiring and guiding the people towards the achievement of the goals. Management is an art of directing and inspiring the people. Only a very good manager can do this work of inspiring and guiding the people for the completion of the work which they need. So, we can define the goals of management in 5 M's. Men refers to the human beings, the teachers, the students, the headmaster, the non-teaching staff, everybody inside the campus of a school. Material. The material resources, namely the building, classrooms, infrastructure facilities, everything. Money. The amount which is spent and earned over the school campus. Machine. The machines which are utilized for functioning of the school. Then methods. What are the methods or the ways of teaching or the approaches of teaching, conducting examination, everything comes under method. Thus, the goals of management can be explained in 5 M's. What are they? Men, material, money, mission and method. Definition given by James L. Londy. Management is principally the task of planning, coordinating, motivating and controlling the efforts of others towards specific objective. I hope this definition clearly explains what are the steps involved in management. Then we will see the next definition given by Joseph L. Massey. Management is a process by which a cooperative group directs action towards common goals. You know, this educational management is not a simple process. The functions of educational management can be explained in terms of these steps, namely planning, organizing, staffing, directing, coordination, reporting and budgeting. So it is indicated by the word postcard. Now this figure tells you about the functions or the process involved in educational management. You know, both education and management are interrelated field. In different situation of the educational process, the management plays a very important role. The first role is that educational planning. For the successful functioning of any organization, we need an effective planning. Then, coming to the next, educational objectives. You know, every institution will have certain objectives to be attained. These objectives may be short-term or long-term in nature. If the objective is achievable, it is very easy to decide the functions. If the educational functions are directed in the right path, we will have surely good educational outcomes. The outcomes are nothing but the results. The results of a school tells the functioning of a school. So, after the results have come, we have to find out whether our plans have worked out or not. Is that any setback in it? What are the ways to overcome those difficulties? And it should be reported to the administration so that they will take the necessary action in future. So, the process of educational management can be studied in these 5 steps. Educational planning, educational objectives, educational functions, educational outcomes and educational administration. Today, I am going to move with Unit 4. The title of the unit is Head Teacher as a School Manager. I hope you know who is the head teacher of a school. Yeah, you are right, the HM. HM is called as a school manager. How he could manage the things better? What is his role? What are the skills he need to have as an HM will be discussed in this unit. You can see here the importance of headmaster. Headmaster is a person who can be referred to a captain of a ship. You know, the safe journey of the passengers depends upon the captain. Likewise, the children's education in a school is depend upon the skill and ability of a headmaster, and hence he is called as the captain of a ship. The headmaster can also be called as the hub of the educational process. Hub, which means he is the person around which all the educational activities are linked together. Even if a small changes is to be brought in the school environment, it is only through the activities of the HM. He can be called as a watch mainspring and can also be referred to like the flywheel of a machine. A HM needs to be a sound and an effective leader, and the success of a school reflects and proclaims the character of a HM. I hope with this you know what is the role of a HM in a school. He should be like a captain, a hub of the educational process, a watch mainspring, flywheel of a mission, so that he reflects and proclaims the character of the school. Importance of a headmaster. The headmaster of a school can be considered as a keystone of the school. We identify certain places by its landmark, isn't it? Likewise, a headmaster is considered as a seal and the school is a wax. So like the seal, like will be the impressions. In what way the HM can be a keystone? He can be a keystone if he is a good organizer, leader, governor, business director, teacher, coordinator, friend, philosopher and guide. Headmaster can also be called as a gardener of the school. You know the work of a gardener. A gardener takes care of the plants in his garden, nourishes them, prunes them when it is needed, and provide them the necessary support for the healthy growth of the plants. Likewise, a HM should be a gardener who tends every plant, every person in the school campus, and he cares them with his love, affection, guidance, so that the whole environment blossoms with success and happiness. Headmaster and his qualities. You know, a headmaster should have certain skills and abilities to run the institution in a successful way. Number one, administrative skills. He should know how to administer the school, how to manage the people, how to make the people work and done the task. He should have an organizing skill, able to get people from various disciplines and organize various kinds of programs inside the school for the betterment of the students and the staff members. He should have a very good communication skill to convey his ideas to the others. He should have a democratic attitude where he will allow everybody to work with a sense of freedom and happiness. He should have sympathetic attitude. He should help the poor, needy and the backward students and understand the problems of the parents and the students. He should be a dynamic natured. He should be ready to accept the changes in the system of education and the modifications in the society. He should have a sound judgment about the people
around him. You should have a sociability skills. The very important thing is you should also have some personal habits which are very clean. Supervising and guiding others. If a HM is going to have all these skills and qualities, then he can be an efficient manager of the school. Head teacher as a school manager. We have already studied the qualities needed for a HM, and thus the success of a school system depends upon his ability and skill, and he should be an effective and a sound educational leader and a manager of the things. Then what is his role? The HM has two major roles to play in the school. Number one, academic role, and then administrative role. Academic aspects which the headmaster should concentrate are listed below. Number one, inspection and supervision. Two, guidance. Three, maintenance of standard. Four, institutional evaluation. Five, preparation of timetable. Six, conduction of subject clubs. Organizing co-curricular activities. The administrative role of a HM can be studied in these headings. Number one, institutional planning. Number two, budgeting. Number three, mobilization of the resources and supervision. Organization of the staff meeting. Then maintenance of different kinds of registers and records. Then district information system for education. He should maintain the records so that he can give the government what is the present status of the school, what is its achievement, how many number of students are studying in the school, etc. can be given through the DISE. Then maintaining of the school discipline. We have already seen the academic and the administrative role of a HM. Now I am going to discuss the difference between inspection and supervision. Normally when the word inspection comes to our mind, we know that it is mostly official in nature, whereas supervision is done for guiding others. I hope you are able to see here the basic differences between inspection and supervision. Number one, inspection is done in a bureaucratic mode, whereas supervision is done in a democratic mode. You can be little bit legible in doing the things. You can be little bit of free in doing the supervision, but inspection is done very strictly and in an orderly manner. Then administration nature, or it is official inspection, whereas supervision can be done both for academic and administrative purposes. Inspection always helps to improve the teaching process or the management, whereas supervision helps to improve the learning process. In inspection, orders will be given and it has to be strictly followed, whereas in supervision, suggestions are provided so that the individual will accept it and modify themselves. Inspection is more of fault finding and checking the efficiency, whereas supervision guidance and counseling will be given to the person so that they will refine themselves. I hope with this you can know what is the basic differences between inspection and supervision. So a HM has to do both these roles. He should also inspect the things and also supervise the people. So he should be knowing where to inspect and where to supervise. Now let us see the definition of supervision. Supervision is an effort taken to stimulate, coordinate and guide the continued growth of the teachers both individually and collectively. According to Burton and Bruckner, supervision is an expert technical service aimed at studying and improving cooperatively all the factors which affect the child's growth and development. This definition is clearly defining that it's a technical service. You know, it's not like a informal way. It's also a technical service which aims to improve all the factors which are needed for the child's growth and development inside the campus. Then, the last point, HM should serve as a good academic supervisor. Role of the supervisor. The supervisor or the HM should be impartial in his evaluation. Impartial means you are not favoring towards anybody or anyone. Then, number two, be sympathetic, friendly and cooperative. You can be sympathetic. The HM can be friendly with the people and he can cooperate along with them also. Then, HM should be democratic in his approach and not assume as a superior. He should behave in a democratic way and not in a superiority way. The supervisor should encourage liberally and correct the erring teachers. He should encourage everybody whenever they do anything good, and also at the same time he should correct the persons who are making mistakes. It might be the teachers or the students or anybody else in the campus. Then, supervisor should avoid prejudice and favoritism. Yes, prejudice, you know, assumption, one-sided assumption about the people or the things, that should be avoided. Before rightly knowing a person, you should not judge them. That's a prejudice. So supervisor should avoid prejudice and favoring the people. Supervisor should offer constructive criticism for the development of the school. Whatever they criticize, it should be helping towards the growth of the school, not to the downward of the process. Every suggestion the supervisor gives or provides should be like a feedback that will motivate the people to work towards the betterment. There are some principles used in supervising the things. What are they? Comprehensive and thorough. Comprehensive, complete. It should be a complete supervision. It should not be done in a halfway. Okay. Then, supervision is related to the whole work of the teacher and the students. All the work should be supervised properly. The purpose of supervision should be positive and not negative. Yeah. Facilitate professional growth of the teachers and development of the school. It should facilitate for the career upliftment of the teachers and also for the development of the school. The supervision should be done on a regular basis and it should be properly maintained in a note so that the next person or the HM or some other person from the management, when they are able to go through the notes, they will be able to get a clear idea about what has been done during the process of supervision. Then, supervision should be well planned and the evaluation tools must be kept ready and the procedures to be adopted should be very clear in nature. Aims of supervision. You know, any work is done with certain aims. Likewise, supervision is done to improve the classroom teaching. Then, ensuring correct and adequate performance by the institution and also the teachers. By supervising, we will be able to get a clear idea whether the institution is working in the right path and the teachers are also going in the right track. Then, satisfactory implementation of the curriculum. The curriculum, what is the syllabus which is given by the government, whether it is followed in the school, whether the methodology adopted for teaching curriculum is suitable or not, will all be studied in this heading. Then, stimulating, coordinating and guiding the efforts of the teacher. Supervision should be done to stimulate, coordinate and guide the teachers in their efforts of teaching to the students. Then, supervision is done to provide in-service training for the professional growth of the teachers. So, when we supervise and give the guidance to the teacher, they will be able to know how to improvise themselves, how to excel in their proficiency towards teaching. Then, ensuring continuous evaluation of the students. So, supervision is done in a continuous basis so that we will be very clearly able to understand whether the students have improved in their academic performance or not. Then, supervision is done to find out the genuine difficulties faced by the teachers and offering correct solutions to solve them also. So, for this only we are using the action research. The teachers inside the classrooms, they face many problems in conveying the lessons to the students or in conducting the exams. There are many difficulties which are faced by them. So, in order to provide solutions to these problems, we conduct the research, we study the factors and we find some solutions. So, this is what done through the supervision. The role of a headmaster in academic supervision. So far we have seen the supervision, its aims, principles and what are the objectives of doing a supervision. Now we will study about what is the role of a HM in doing the academic supervision. HM should inspect all the classes. First he should go around the campus. He should have an inspection of all the classes, whether it's neat, clean, tidy, whether the teachers and the students are carrying their work properly. Everything should be checked by him. HM should periodically check the work of the students and take measures to improve the backward students. He should periodically go through the progress report of the students and take some measures. If the student is weak in certain subjects, he should arrange for some tuition classes or some special classes, and even sometimes he can conduct some special talk with the students. Personally, he can talk with them, guide them and motivate them to learn more. Then, HM should observe the classroom teaching and find out the instructional strategy and the methodology adopted by the teachers. He should check their teaching notes, diaries, etc. to find out their work. HM should supervise without disturbing the class work. The classroom supervision done by a HM should not disturb the routine work of the class. And he should not point out the defects in the teaching before the students. Instead, he can call the teacher in person and make them realize what is their mistake and how they can rectify themselves. So this will develop a cordial relationship with the students and the staffs in general. The HM can arrange expert guidance services. He should often conduct the regular staff meetings to know about the functioning of the school. He can implement, he can buy and supply certain technological tools to improve the teaching competency and the teaching methodology of the teachers. Thank you. I hope you are clear with the academic role of a HM and what is the aims, principles, and how a HM can be a good academic supervisor. Thank you.